This is not straight.
Hello, teacher.
Yes.
Can you give me the picture, please?
I can bring it back here.
Okay, thank you. Okay, finish. Thank you.
No problem. Yeah. Okay, good morning, everybody. Hope you all had a wonderful Christmas break. So last week was Jane, so I'm back now. Next week is also Jane, so we'll be alternating with our Monday class. All right. So you get one of us 1 week and then the other one of us the other week. So for this sketch, as always, we start with landmarking. In this picture, the two major players are, you see the plant and then you see the shadow. And in this picture, both of these have equal importance. They're the same size even. So we will sketch both the plant and the shadow. Okay. Let's begin by marking out where our plant will be. So I'd like to make my house plant quite big. I'm using HB, but you can use an F pencil or anything light. Okay. So my plant will take up most of my page here. I'm going to say the top of it will be maybe around here, and I'll draw a line. And then it's going to be about this wide. So it's going to take up this square. So then I know kind of where my plant will be. And then for the shadow, it will take up roughly the same amount of space. So you can imagine this space and then double it on this side. This is good if you're outside and you're trying to sketch a landscape. Try to map out how big all of the things are without drawing the things first. So you can say, okay, this house is about this big. This tree is about twice the size of the house. The car is about half the size of the house. Then it makes it easier for you to start drawing. And then once you have done that, you can see this is a big shape. The pot starts about, I would say here. So this is where my pot is going to be. Not this big, but just a line for my pot. Okay, so now I can start to give rough outlines as to where my things are going to be. So for this one, we can start with the pot. So let's start with the shape of the pot. And then the top is curved. And then this, for this part, you just want to match the top curve. I don't think it's actually this much is showing. I'm gonna make this one a little bit smaller. And then make sure you do the same for the shadow. So the shadow of this one is it's a little bit warped. Say we start right here. So it's a lot smaller, it's off to the side. And it's something like that. And then you can begin to put all the leaves on the plant. This one is like almost a circle. remember, it doesn't have to look like the picture at all. You can make things up as you go. And then one more right here. I think my pot is too big, but that is okay. We'll leave it like that. And then we can start drawing the other plant shadow. There is a line across the page here, or the wall, so you can't include that. You might find it helpful to have a ruler or a straight surface. So I will put that line in. It's a little bit slanted towards this side. So you get something like that. Oh, and I need two of them. Okay, now this one can be a bit bigger. And then using this line as a reference, so we can start to draw out the shadow. I think this one can be a little bit smaller. Just adjust it as you go. Of course, at this point, you can erase all these other construction lines. And then we will begin filling in our sketch. Oh, I forgot one thing. It's very important. So we need to mark out where all these shadowed areas are. For example, right here. So mark out wherever you see the most shadow, or on this side. This picture is okay because you can see clear areas where there is a shadow. Right here. Or on this leaf as well. And especially on the pot here. So right over here and here. Then I can go and erase all my construction lines. And then we'll just wait a couple minutes for everybody to finish their sketches. This one's so wonky. Okay, let's continue. So you will need to use your darkest pencil, which is probably 6B, but I will use this one right here because mine is very small. So take your darkest pencil and using that, we will begin to fill in these shadow areas. So I'm gonna be going in one direction. Like this. So find all the shadow areas and begin filling them out. Also, I realized I think I forgot to draw one of these leaves. I totally forgot to draw this one right up here. There's one in between. Let's add that now. And start filling in this dark leaf. So go in one direction for now. If you're using charcoal, you can fill it in, and then afterwards, you can blend it together. And for this one, we forgot to mark it out. Notice that the center for some of the leaves is a little bit lighter, this very center here. So keep filling in these areas. As for what direction to draw in, it doesn't really matter. For the super dark shadow areas. And then you see as I get towards the middle, I'm using less and less pressure on the pencil. And then for the most time consuming part is we have to sketch out this entire thing, this entire shadow over here. Before we do that, I'm going under this line here and making it dark because there's a shadow right under that. So this part is very dark, right underneath that pole right there. And then you can also sketch out, there's a light shadow behind here that you can sketch out as well. I think the easier way to do this is to look for the areas that are not shadow and draw those out instead, if most of it is shadow. It's a little bit like coloring. Okay. And then I have to sketch out this entire thing. I'm still using the darkest pencil, but I'm applying less pressure. For this shadow, it's mostly the same. There's not too much variation, so you just really have to fill it in. Oh, there is a little bit of variation right here. That's everything. So just make that little end piece a little bit lighter. Just take your time filling it in. And I get to fill in the rest of this plant. It's like a morning coloring session. Keep going. So if you turn your pencil on the side and you make large motions, you'll be able to cover more space and evenly. But it takes a bit of practice to do. And then once you are done that, you can go ahead, make dark parts darker, or take a break. And if you're not done the first shadow part, keep going, you can do it. Some arm strength. Oh no, my pencil is broken. Freaking broken. It's okay, I'll keep using it. So I am using the lead that broke to make some areas darker. You just want to make some parts darker, like right underneath. Okay, and then we'll wait a couple minutes for everybody to work on this and then come back and finish the rest. Okay, let's continue. So now all there's left to do is fill in the remaining areas. And I'm going to use a lighter pencil to do this. So now going in one direction, I get to fill in the rest of the areas. So this time I'm trying to go in the direction of the leaf. And then you can put a couple of darker lines in there. So it'll all start kind of coming together once you fill in these areas. So notice that this one, I'm going in the opposite direction as I did for this one, so I can have some interesting texture. Remember, this one is called, this technique is called cross hatching. Like with this one, just pay attention to which direction the leaf pattern is going in. And you can fill it in according to that. Let's do this one first. This one's darker. And then let's do this one. And then from here, you just keep going. Make these darker parts darker still, so they're not dark enough right here. And then you can add a couple of darker markings onto the leaf. Okay. Okay. And just keep going until, well, you can keep going forever, but for this one, there's another thing you can add, but that would require a very skinny eraser. If you don't have that, you can use a white charcoal to draw out. See, this one is not working. You can try to draw out those lines. I'm not sure if it will work on graphite. Or if you're using charcoal, you can do this for sure. But if you have an eraser, it will work better. This one my dog chewed up. So the idea is to create lines, white lines inside the plant. almost done here. So I'm just going through and making some of those darker shadows darker and the lighter ones. I guess I'm not making them lighter, but you can. So using your eraser or the white charcoal, if that works for you, you can try to bring out some of these lighter areas. And you can always go back in the background to add some more shadows if you want, or you can leave it. If you want to add a shadow on the wall. And then with that, I think this one is done. Oh, this glare. So much glare coming from that light. How do I see gallery? Does anyone want to show their work so far? The end of class. That's very nice, everybody. I see that. Hi, Jerry. Very nice, Angela. Good job, everybody. I like this one. It's so cute. Awesome, Rebecca.
Okay.
Indy. Ying Chen, I see all of this. So cool. Thank you, everybody, for showing your work. This one is fun. All right, everybody. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, Julie.
Yeah. See you next week or next 2 weeks.
See you next 2 weeks. Next week, you guys will be.